In this vlog, we are going to see how we are able to fetch data from an API using Getex library. So I will be showing you the easiest way. So if you are a beginner, I suggest you to follow this tutorial till the end so that you will be getting a good knowledge on how the Getex library works. And also we have a playlist of Getex tutorial which covers a beginner level series of tutorials where we have discussed more information in detail on Getex library implementation. I am providing the link in the description section below and I suggest you to go through it before getting started with this tutorial. So now let's get started. So here, the first thing we are going to do is like we are adding get to our dependencies here to make use of Getex library in our Flutter application. So this is the current latest version. I suggest you to add the latest version available. So now let's go through the main.dart file here. So this is our basic coding which we see for every application. We are starting with our void main, and inside run app we are going to specify my app, which is extending a stateless widget. So here we are trying to return a get material app. So as I have specified you to go through our previous tutorials on Getex, I have specified there why we are making use of get material app instead of material app. So in short, I'm going to say you, whenever you are trying to make use of the Getex library implementations, you need to make use of get material app. And for the more information, you may refer our previous tutorials. So here we have specified initial root and get pages. So we have created a package roots here, and inside which we have created a roots class. So we have declared a static final roots, and here we have specified only one page for now because we are having only one screen. And whenever you have a requirement of multiple screens, you can just add the pages. We have a screen data, and for which we have data binding, and we have represented it here so that we can easily move to that particular screen. So if you observe here, we have provided initial root as slash data here, and generally it will be like your home screen, but here I'm trying to redirect to the data screen directly. So I have specified the same here. So whenever your app loads, it will directly make use of the initial root and divert to data screen here. So before getting into the data class, let's see the provider class once. So here we have created a provider class inside the provider directory here. So why I have specified separate directories for every file is like whenever you are trying to build a real-time application, then you might be having different screens and you need to categorize them according to this particular structure here. So to make it easier for you to understand, I have structured in this particular order now. So now let's see what's the provider class and what it does. So here in the class provider, we are extending getConnect. So using getConnect, we are trying to connect with the API and trying to fetch the data. So for which we have created a method getUser, which is of a type future. So it's an asynchronous method, so we are trying to fetch the data on API call. We are making use of future here. Here we are going to capture the data which we are trying to fetch making use of a network call. So we are using future here, and which is of a type dynamic. So if you are having any queries why we are making use of dynamic here, so we have not specified any type of data here, and it's of a type dynamic so that we can accept any type of data here. So here I have specified final response and here await. So we are making use of a get network call here. So there are different types of calls like get here we are making use, and also if you want, also we have specified final response is equal to await of get here. So we are making use of a get call here. You can also have post, put, patch, depending upon your requirement here. So we are making use of a get call, and I have specified get here, and inside which we have specified the URL. So if you want to generate your own URL here, I'm going to specify you how I have created this URL. So here you can see, using the jsongenerator.com website, I have added the data which I required to be present in the API. So here you can see this is our output, and once you copy the JSON file URL here, you can just open it and you can check whether the data is perfect or not. And now inside the provider class, you can just specify the URL here, and if response.status has error, so if there is any error in this particular URL, then we are going to print a data showing the same onto the screen so that the user can understand that there is some error in the URL and he need to check. And if everything is okay and we got the data and we are trying to return the data by making use of response.body here. So if you are having any specified array list there, so you can just specify it over here. Like generally you are having a result kind of array list. I'm just specifying for an example. So here we don't have any array list name here. I'm just specifying response.body itself. So now let's move to the controller class here. So the data controller extending getX controller here. So what is a getX controller? GetX controller are the classes where we put all our business logics like variables, methods. We make use of this particular class and we access them in our view. So to populate the view, we make use of this GetX controller classes here. And you may think that we can directly provide the data in our class. What is the need for making use of a GetX controller? So whenever you are trying to make use of the GetX controller here, we can have control over the memory consumption of our application. Like we can automatically dispose the controllers whenever we don't require them, and we need not provide any particular command to do so. The GetX controller will automatically get disposed when there is no requirement. And this GetX controller will have two methods, like init and close. You can see we have specified them. So these methods will replace the init state and dispose method of a stateful widget which we are using. We can completely avoid a stateful widget and make use of this GetX controller and write a highly organized code. So this is why we are making use of a GetX controller here with state mixin. And what is a mixin? So whenever you are trying to make use of data which is present in multiple classes, so as we have a support of only single inheritance, we will make use of mixin over here. And if you want more information on mixins, do let me know in the comment section below. I will try to make a separate tutorial so that you can understand them in much detail. So now let's continue back with this tutorial here. So now in init, so inside init we are going to specify provider. So previously we have created a provider, right? Provider.getUser and dot then. So this is our value, and we are going to specify change here. The help of a change here, we are going to specify the state and status here. So what is the state? The value which we are trying to fetch is the state here, and the status whether it is success or not. So if it is success, we are going to specify rx status.success here, and or if we received any error, we are going to specify the same error over here, and we are trying to convert the error message to string. So now we have not specified in onClose anything for now. We will be seeing later on. And now let's specify the data binding here. We have also specified a class data binding which is extending bindings here, and using which we are going to specify our dependencies here. So our dependency is like our data controller, and using get.lazyput we are trying to specify this. So why we are using lazyput here is like it will create the dependencies immediately, but it will load the memory only when the get is called for the first time. So whenever the root is removed and created again, lazyput will not load them again. So get.lazyput loads dependencies only one time, which means that if the root gets removed and created again, lazyput will not load them again. So here we have specified our data controller, and if you are having multiple controllers, you can just specify them here in this way. So now let's get back to the data.dart file here. And here we are extending get view of type data controller here. So here we are trying to make use of the data which we have fetched by making use of a network call and trying to populate it to our data class here. I think you remember from main.dart we are routing to this data.dart class here. So inside which we are trying to return a scaffold, and inside the appr we have provided a default title like getex network call, and inside the body we are making use of the controller. We have specified a data controller, right? We are making use of the controller.obx. So I have done a detailed tutorial on why we are making use of obx. So what is controller and why we are making use, I will be provided in the description section below, or else you can just refer to our getex playlist. There you will be finding this particular tutorial, and you can watch and you can get much details in that particular tutorial. So now we are trying to fetch the data here using our controller, and again a general coding, like I am specifying a column here which is in the center of the screen, and I am providing the main axis alignment to the center so that our data appears in the center of the screen. And here I have specified a children, as we are making use of a column here, so inside which I have provided a circular avatar, and for making an image which is in circular shape. So you can, and this is again an optional thing, I'm just trying to populate the data here. So here you can see in our API we got some name, ID, picture, age, gender and all these kinds of fields. So I'm trying to populate picture. I'm provided the radius like 80 here and background image of type network image. So we are trying to load the image from the URL, right? So data. So using controller we are making use of this data here. Here you can see we are trying to return body, right? So inside the body we are having this particular data. So I am specifying picture here. So you can remember the key values here, name, ID, picture. So just make use of them here, data of picture. So you will be getting an image URL, and using network image you are trying to populate it. And I have provided some space by making use of a sized box here and height of 20. I am also trying to populate the name here. So data of name, email and company. So don't confuse here, I'm just making use of the key names here, and you can just replace them according to your requirement, and have provided some spaces in between them. So now let's try to see the output here. So here you can see this is our output here. So here you can see we have got an image, a name, email ID, and this is the name of the company here. So here you can see inside the provider we have specified the URL, right? So let's see that if we have provided a wrong URL, or whenever there is some error in the URL. Here you can see we can clearly get an error occurred, not found. So by making use of this particular text you can just check whether the URL is working or not and make the changes accordingly. So if the data is loading, we can get to know that the URL is working perfectly and we got the data out of it. So in this way we can just make use of the network call using getex library, and I hope you understood this topic. And if you are having any queries, do let me know in the comment section below, and I am providing the entire code link in the description section below. So I suggest you to go through our getex tutorial playlist which is available in the description section below, and if you like this tutorial do share it with your friends so that the more people can benefit out of this particular tutorials. So if you like this tutorial do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.